A vector could mean many things. First, the easiest one to understand is vectors as coordinates. This is a kind of vector I'm going to be talking about in this video, but just in case you're confused, std vector in C++ is a different kind of a vector where you have contiguous memory blocks of a certain data type. If you don't understand what this means, I recommend watching the previous videos in this playlist. Anyways, there's nothing too complex about coordinates. You see it all the time in game dev, but a vector can mean a lot more than just the position on a grid. Here's a little project I built to visualize it. I did it in Unity, and don't worry if you don't know anything about Unity because this video is only about the concept. So here's a coordinate, but if you look at it from 0, 0, it's more like an arrow. And of course, every arrow has its own length. Depending on the starting point and the end point, you can have different length as well as different directions. You can start the arrow from anywhere you want, but you can still keep the same direction and length of the arrow. This will be an important reoccurring theme in this video, but don't worry for now if you don't understand why. Just know that if you have a vector that goes from point A to point B, it's not all that different from a vector that starts at 0, 0 that has the same length and direction. Oftentimes in game dev, you'll see an operation that looks like this. What does it mean to add two vectors? Visually, this is easy to understand. Vector A plus vector B is vector C. All you're doing is connecting lines. I've created this scene in Unity, but again, this is not about Unity. It's about visualizing this in your head and understanding it. You can do this in any other engine, language, or program. It's also easy to understand that when it comes to vectors, A plus B is the same as B plus A. As you can see, I can switch between the two, but the final endpoint of the result remains the same. The question is, why should you learn about these things? Well, here's an example. Let's say there's a chase cam that follows a player. How would you get the position of the camera when the player is constantly moving? It's simple. In this example, the camera is always at a certain distance away from the player. So you get the player position and then add that distance in X and Y and you get the camera position. Of course, in 3D, you're adding X, Y, and Z, but the operation is the same. We call this relative position of the camera to the player. So no matter where the player is, we get the player position, which is a vector, and then we add another vector, which is a relative position of the camera. In our scene, we apply the same concept. Vector A could be the player position and vector B would be the relative position of the camera. You can also change each of the vectors in any way that you want at any time. How you change those two vectors will give you different looks to your game, just like a movie. Here's the same concept in 3D. Here's position 0, here's vector A, and vector B. No matter where the green box is, the relative position of the red box doesn't change. In numbers, it would look like this, and you'll notice that 2D vectors and 3D vectors work exactly the same. Mathematically, you can expand this to 4D or 5D or 6D. The operation itself never changes. We don't really know what a 4D vector looks like, but on an abstract level, in terms of numbers, we can still express it. For the most part, we're only concerned about 2D and 3D vectors in a video game, so we're not going to go too far. But just understand that when it comes to vector arithmetics, the operations don't change whether you're working in 2D or 3D. Let's talk about the other operation, minus. When you do a vector A minus vector B, it's the same process, X minus X and Y minus Y. In case with 3D, you also do Z minus Z. Visually, it's slightly different from adding. In case with A minus B, you're getting a vector from B to A. If you go the other way, B minus A is like saying from A to B. So in case with minus, A minus B is not the same as B minus A. And it's a reoccurring theme again. This vector, when the length and direction are identical, isn't all that different from this vector. Here's a scene visualized in Unity. Where would you use something like this? Let's say you have the player firing a bullet towards the enemy. You have enemy position minus player position, which will give you relative vector from player position to enemy position. The next step is simply sending a projectile to that direction. The problem is if you add this vector to the projectile, it'll be teleporting from player position to enemy position in a single frame. One of the choices you have is making incremental changes on every single frame so it looks like the projectile is flying over to that position. So we add a certain amount of vector on every single frame. This involves keeping the direction but shortening the length of the arrow and adding that vector on every single frame. Lengthening or shortening a vector involves multiplication. I don't want to talk about too many things in one video, so for this one, if you've understood what it means to add two vectors or subtract one vector from another, you've gotten the point. Before you move on, please make sure to understand the visualization of adding and subtracting vectors, and I'll talk more about vectors in the next video. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. All the links are in the description. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.